Hello, I'm Ty Mason of the DiabetesCouncil.com, researcher, writer, and I have type 2 diabetes. Now, I want to emphasize that my perspective is coming from one with type 2 diabetes and not type 1. Our channel is primarily for those with type 2 diabetes and pre-diabetes. Today, I want to answer the question, how is pre-diabetes different from type 2 diabetes? After you watch the video today, I invite you to check out the description box for my new ebook. This is one of the most comprehensive diabetes meal planning books you'll find anywhere. It contains diabetes-friendly meals and recipes, recipes for different goals such as 800 to 1800 calories per day meal plans, diabetes meal planning tips and tricks, and there are also tons of diabetes-friendly recipes for everyone. We hear the term diabetes and automatically think we know what it is, right? Well, those of us with diabetes probably do know that there are two or three, maybe, depending on how you want to classify it, types of diabetes. Some will call pre-diabetes a form of diabetes, and I guess that is true, kind of like preschool is kind of like school. Now, I'm not saying it's any less serious. It is just that pre means before, and those with pre-diabetes are at a high risk to get type 2 diabetes. They just haven't gotten it yet. Then there are type 1 and type 2 diabetes, and also don't forget about gestational diabetes. Now, in this video, I'm going to attempt to give you the similarities and differences in pre-diabetes and type 2. That is the target audience of our channel. Diabetes affects approximately 30 million Americans today, and an astonishing 86 million people have been diagnosed with pre-diabetes, or will be. Half of the adults in the United States either have or will have diabetes or pre-diabetes. Now, diabetes is a disorder of the endocrine system. With diabetes, blood sugar levels stay high because either the pancreas can no longer produce enough insulin, or the cells of the body are resistant to the insulin that the pancreas does use and the pancreas can't keep up. Now, either way, the glucose or sugar level in the bloodstream becomes too high and the body cannot function properly. Now, as we said, in the U.S., 86 million people have blood glucose levels that are above the normal range, but not high enough to be classified as diabetes. This is known as pre-diabetes. It's also known as impaired glucose tolerance. Now, this type of diabetes, if you want to call it that, is difficult to diagnose because most people with pre-diabetes usually have no symptoms. Now, we have done a video on the symptoms of pre-diabetes. I encourage you to check that one out. Pre-diabetes is almost always present before a person develops type 2. Without symptomology, however, it's hard to diagnose because most people don't go see a doctor if they have no symptoms of a disease. I mean, let's face it, you're not going to go see a doctor if you're not sick, at least if you do not perceive that you are sick. Complications normally associated with diabetes, such as heart disease, can begin to develop even when the person has pre-diabetes. As a matter of fact, a lot of the diseases associated with diabetes can happen to a person with pre-diabetes. We've also done a study on diabetes, pre-diabetes, and the eyes. Did you know you have a 7.6% chance of developing diabetic retinopathy even if you have pre-diabetes? In general, people who have a fasting plasma blood glucose in the 100 to 125 milligrams per deciliter range are defined as having pre-diabetes or impaired fasting glucose. Like many diseases, early detection can be very good. So talk to your doctor about testing for pre-diabetes. You may be able to prevent type 2. Now, moving on to type 2, according to WebMD, type 2 diabetes, the body continues to produce insulin, although insulin production by the body may significantly decrease over time. The pancreas produces either not enough or the body is unable to recognize insulin and use it properly. When there isn't enough insulin, or the insulin is not used as it should be, glucose can't get into the body's cells to be used as energy, and this glucose builds up in the blood. Now, this condition was once known as adult onset or non-insulin dependent diabetes. More common in adults, type 2 diabetes increasingly affects children as childhood obesity increases. Now, there's no cure for type 2 diabetes, but you may be able to manage the condition by eating well, exercising, and maintaining a healthy weight. And if diet and exercise aren't enough to manage your blood sugar well, you may need diabetes medications or insulin therapy. Again, the main difference between prediabetes and diabetes is the fact, number one, prediabetes can be reversed, the fact that you do not develop type 2 diabetes. Type 2 diabetes is much tougher to reverse, although it is possible. Also, your blood glucose in prediabetes is not as high as those with type 2 diabetes. In prediabetes, 100 to 125 milligrams per deciliter is considered prediabetes, but 126 and over is type 2 diabetes or even type 1 diabetes. So, the main differences in the two, number one, once again, you can stop prediabetes. Type 2 diabetes can be reversed, but much harder to do so. And basically, the amount of blood glucose in your blood. That's the two main differences, and I hope that this has shed some light on the difference between prediabetes and type 2. Don't forget to get my new ebook, and please subscribe to our channel for many more videos like this one in the future. I want to thank you so much for watching. I'm Ty Mason.